I always emphasize to the student four different aspects of their formation, which is I call it four pillars of the formation. First one, of course, academic. Second one, it is spiritual. Third one is community. Last one is pastoral. So those four aspects, it is connected with each other. I cannot kind of, you know, emphasize or saying to the students academics important and pastoral is second. Four of them are connected. I may start with the first one, it is academic. They are here hold the student visa. So it means they have to finish four subjects at YTU, requested by the government regulation of the immigration department. So it means their focus is, first focus is with their studies. So regardless about their limitation about their language, you know, cultural understanding, or food, or other stuff in their life, but they have to finish at least four subjects a semester. And thanks God, they done well. So even four subjects, they always pass and finish, even some of them with high distinction. So this is the first subject. It is a requirement for the visa purpose and also from the society. So if you like to become priest, at least you have to finish a bachelor degree of theology. The second aspect I said to you, it is about the spiritual aspect, because they are here not just like those other students, overseas students. So they are here because they are seminarian. They are temporary vows of Divine Word Missionaries. They are religious missionaries. So they have a community here. They have to do that recollection regularly, retreat regularly, some seminars regularly, based on the concern of Australian society and church. For example, we are now focusing on the what we call it, the issue about Royal Commission and staff. We need to inform students with a very good and clear understanding what the requirement by the Catholic Church, professional standard especially, how to deal with the children, with the woman, working with the children, with the police clearance and stuff. Even they are religious, they are not exceptional for those regulations from the government. So my point is that I give them, I regularly update them with the professional standard in the formation house, in a religious life and community in Australia. It is part of their spiritual aspect already. Of course, they also have the renewal of vows every year. And then they have, morning mass, morning prayer, a lot of religious activities around, based in the house, not at YTU. It is the second aspect. The third aspect of our formation here in Doris Maru, it is all about the community life. The community life is connected with our theme of the 18th generation chapter, which is happening this year. The love of Christ impels us, rooted in the Word and committed to His mission. So it is, this theme came about based also with our the theme of the previous general chapter before. It is about sharing the multicultural living. We are from many different nations. So in my program here with the students, I emphasize on that, about community living. So my students, they are really small by number, about 11 of them. But I tell you, they come from 4 or 5 different nationalities. We have 3 Vietnamese, 2 Malagasies, 2 Indonesian, 2 Ghanaian, 1 from Laos, and 1 from Mexico. So we are so multicultural. And also we have a seniors conference here who are retired in some level. who are doing their lecturing at YTU. So some from United States, from New Zealand, from I think the Netherlands too, and also even from Ireland. And the rector is Aussie. So we are really living in a really multicultural community. So the students need to learn about dealing with culture shock in some level, but also dealing with our culture differences. So this is the third aspect that I emphasize with the students. And the last aspect, it is about pastoral work. So even they are focusing with their study at YTU with four subjects, I also ask them at least once a week go and doing their pastoral work in many different places here in Victoria. I give you maybe some example with marginalized and the poor, with the homeless people. There are some centers in the city. They also doing their pastoral work with seafarers, pastoral work with prison or jail ministry, also pastoral work in nursing home, in the hospital. So I ask them to do the pastoral work once a week, and after they come back, I also ask them fortnightly or twice a month ministry supervision. They are asked to deal with the issues when they go and do their pastoral work. And I have asked one of ministry supervision, he is really qualified and professional one. They come to that person and dealing with him, share with him, you know, the lights and the shadows, the struggles, and then where is God in that ministry. So not just doing the pastoral work, but also pastoral, or we call it ministry supervision, how to go deep with their pastoral work. So after all, once again, the formation here, it is based on four different aspects or four different pillars. First one is academic. Second one is spirituality. The third one is community life. And the last one is pastoral work.